Here we are for day three of our zoo trip planning. We have actually set ourselves up to be in a really good position for today's work. If you explored your website yesterday, you got an idea of some of the special events or programs that might be happening. And in that, it's possible that you have already seen a list of the animals and the types of things that are at the zoo or aquarium that you have chosen to visit. You hopefully kind of created a budget. You know how much money it's going to cost for you and your friends or your family to take this trip. But we want to know, what are we going to do while we are there? We're going to create a schedule today. So again, based on your exploration of the website, you probably already in your mind have a list of things that you want to see or do while you're visiting your zoo or your aquarium. So that's the big question for today. What do you want to see? What do you want to do while you're at the zoo? So in order to organize that, this is what we want to do. We want to create a detailed schedule of what you want to see and do and when you will do it. Time is going to be very important today. So you might have to revisit the section of the website that talks about the hours of the day, because while you should know what time the park opens, you might want to look at the closing time, because you want to create a detailed schedule, not only what are you doing, but when you're going to do it. So for that organization, I'm picturing you might want to create a chart and have sections for visiting this, but we need to include a start and an end time. So if I want to go see the koala bears, I'm going to put on my chart, starting at 10 o'clock, I want to see the koala bears, and I'm going to be done looking at the koala bears at 10:15. A start and an end time for each item on your list. So that should include, again, any special programs you're choosing to do. That would include planning a break time. Maybe you're just going to take a break because you know you'll be walking a lot. You can plan a break time, and a lunch time also, or a dinner time might be an important part of your day. Include what time that starts and what time it ends. And keep in mind, in order to do everything, you want to make sure it's happening between the opening time of the zoo and the closing time. Finally, once you have your schedule created, calculate, do a final calculation. How much total time are you spending at the zoo? From the time you go in to the time you're done for that day, it might be every single hour that the zoo is open. That's perfectly fine. But maybe you'll plan your day and you'll realize you're leaving a little bit earlier than the zoo closes. The goal is simply, how much total time will you spend there? You'll know that because you'll be able to look at that detailed schedule you've created. Again, each item, this is when we're starting, this is when we're stopping. And then the next item, when does it start, when does it stop? You get to create a detailed schedule. So now at this point, not only do you know how much money we need to make this adventure happen, but also we're going to have the schedule laid out for the day so that we can enjoy each and every moment at the zoo. So enjoy creating your schedule. Hope it's fun for you to do. Hope you get excited thinking about, maybe even in the future, maybe this trip becomes a reality because you will already have information to be able to share with people that you're planning to go with. It might make it a little easier for it to become a reality. So enjoy the process. Keep using your brains. Good luck with your schedule, and I will see you soon.